Artificial intelligence is not future anymore, because this is the present, and that is the reality. So in this entire series, we will be talking about one of the best artificial intelligence tool, which is called as GitHub Copilot. GitHub Copilot is one of the best artificial intelligence tool, and this will help you in all forms, all types of your coding. Irrespective of your programming language, irrespective of your setup, everything will be there in GitHub Copilot. The GitHub Copilot is an artificial intelligence coding assistant tool, and it helps us in all areas of coding. If you want to start the development of a new application, you want the proper structure, the architecture, the programming languages, unit test cases, you want to make a call to some third-party API, everything is there in this GitHub Copilot. This will help you in all phases of your development. GitHub Copilot is free and paid, and this is a product from Microsoft. Why I am saying this is free and paid? This is because if you are going to use GitHub Copilot, then you will have to pay a fee. The fee is not that much. We will talk about that also when we will talk about the plans of the GitHub Copilot. But there is a free version also. The free version does not include so many things, but this is the best thing if you want to get started with this GitHub Copilot. So if you are totally new to GitHub Copilot, then I would suggest to start with this free plan, and ultimately you will have to move to the paid plan. Now let's talk about how this GitHub Copilot will help you in your coding in your system. So basically in your editor, there will be a separate window that will help you to give the suggestion, hey, that now you have to write this code, now follow this step. You can also make the changes inline. So it means you are having a file, and let's say you are working on some function, then you can simply tell, hey, GitHub Copilot, I want to work on this function. Can you please help me write down that? So GitHub Copilot will do that. There is one more agent mode, and the agent mode will do everything for your programming. You simply have to tell the instructions, and GitHub Copilot will generate all the files. Everything will be done by the GitHub Copilot. I am using this GitHub Copilot since a very long time, and this is an amazing tool. If you want to use the GitHub Copilot, then you will have to create an account on this github.com. You can use your personal account or an organization level account that you are using in your company. Okay, so let's navigate to this github.com. Let's assume that you have created a new GitHub account. Now navigate to the profile section, and there is this setting button over here. Now at this page, you can scroll down a little bit, and here on the left hand side, you will notice you are having this Copilot. So let's just click on this Copilot thing, and here will be some instructions about your GitHub Copilot. Just follow these instructions and GitHub Copilot will be done in your GitHub account. Now we have to integrate this GitHub Copilot to our local system editor, which could be Visual Studio, Visual Studio Code, or if you are using something from JetBrains, Vim, there are so many editors. You can use this GitHub Copilot in almost all the popular editors. In this series, I will be focusing on two editors. One is the VS Code, which is called as Visual Studio Code, and second is the Visual Studio. Before setting up all these things, let's understand how much we have to pay if we are going to use GitHub Copilot for the first time or maybe after some time. Alright, so for that, let's click this official link over here. If I scroll down to the bottom side, then you will notice as of today, we are having 5 plans over here. These 3 plans are for the individuals, and for the business, there are 2 plans over here. Okay, so the first plan is this free plan, and in this free plan, you don't have to pay anything. You don't even have to provide your credit card details. Everything is totally free of cost, but there are some limitations over here. What is the limitation? You can use only 2000 completion per month, 50 agent mode and chat request per month. So you can read all these things over here, but ultimately, if you are going to use this GitHub Copilot for longer time and you are a full-time developer, then I would suggest to go with this pro version. Hey, you have to pay only $10 per month or maybe $100 per year. Remember, these things can change in future, but this is the plan as of today. So if you are totally new to GitHub Copilot and you are just trying how this will work, then you can use this free version. Now let's open the editors and set up this GitHub Copilot over there. So first I will open this VS Code, and this is the latest version of VS Code that I'm using. You can download this VS Code free of cost from the official website. Now, to use this GitHub Copilot, you have to go to the extensions and you have to search for the GitHub Copilot. Here I have already installed that GitHub Copilot. Once you will install this GitHub Copilot in VS Code, then you will notice that there are 2 extensions that are installed. First is this GitHub Copilot, and second is this GitHub Copilot chat. So this will give you the entire experience of the GitHub Copilot. Once the installation is done, then you will have to log into your GitHub account. How to do that? So here you can click on this chat button. Let's first click on this chat button, and you will notice that this is opening a new window over here on the right hand side. If you are opening this window for the first time, then you'll get a prompt to log in with your GitHub account. You can click on that button and simply log into your GitHub account. And if you have enabled the GitHub Copilot in that account, then automatically this will be enabled for you. Let's focus first on the Visual Studio and see how GitHub Copilot will work over there. So this is my Visual Studio. Here I'm using this latest version. This is a preview version. enterprise version, but this is applicable in community and the professional version also. If you are using this version 17.1, then you will get this GitHub Copilot automatically installed in your Visual Studio. If you are using some older version, then you will have to install the extensions. So for that, you can simply click on this extensions, manage extensions, search for the GitHub Copilot and just install that. But if you are using this latest version, then GitHub Copilot is already a part of your Visual Studio. Here you can notice on the top right side, there is a button GitHub Copilot and there is this green tick as well. So it means this GitHub Copilot is active. For the first time, if you will open it, then this green tick will not be there. And similar to Visual Studio Code, you will have to log in over here with your GitHub account. Once the login is done, and how will you get that login window? Again, click over here and click on this open chat window. So by default over here, you will get that login prompt. Now let's write some message just to check how this GitHub Copilot is working. So here, make sure that you are using this ask over here. We'll talk about what that is. There is ask agent mode. If I go to this VS Code, then here also you will notice that there are three buttons, agent, ask, edit. So we will learn all of them one by one. First, we will start with this ask, then we'll focus on edit, and then later in the agent mode also. So let's write some couple of messages. Hello Copilot, I am new to GitHub Copilot. So this GitHub Copilot will take some time and it will help you to understand everything over here. See, here I'm writing, why should I learn the GitHub Copilot? There is one more very important thing over here. Whenever you will write the command to the GitHub Copilot, chances are that you will never get the same exact response every time you will search for that. Why? This is because there is no hard-coded thing at the backend side. This is a model. Based on your input, it will analyze everything based on how it has been trained, and then it will give you a response. So chances are that you might get some different answers, and sometimes you may get some wrong answers as well. In the next video, you will develop a real-time application by using this GitHub Copilot. And if you don't know anything about the programming, or maybe you are coming from some different background, for example, the BA, project manager, then you can still create the programming web application in your system by using this GitHub Copilot. But at the end of this video, I will assume that you have a working GitHub Copilot environment in your system and you are able to connect to the GitHub Copilot. And again, I'm saying this, if you are just trying what this GitHub Copilot is, then do not go for the paid plan for the first time. Just simply try the free version. And if you are a full-time programmer, then ultimately, after some time, you will have to go with the paid plan. That is all in this video. I will see you in the next one. Thank you for watching. Have a great day.